Happy Wednesday, you guys. We got a cool little work set for you guys. We're gonna go for some walking or some holding. So we got a couple options for you today. We'll break that down momentarily, and then we'll talk first about this little warm up here we got for you. So first things first, inchworm knee to nose, 3 to 5. Working on a little bit of upper body and a little bit of core work here. Into our plank to plank walkout. So instead of an inchworm walkout, we're just gonna lift from plank to walkout to plank to walkout. So we'll have some fun there. 3 to 5 reps with a 3 second hold in both positions. Moving forth onto the floor, arch hold, so a static hold for 5 to 10 seconds. They're gonna do 10 alternating arch ups, so 10 total count reps of alternating back and forth from side to side. Finishing off with a little single leg RDL or back scale, depending on what you're more comfortable with. We have 5 to 8 reps per side with a relatively light load. We're just using it to kind of heat up the hamstrings for what's to come. 2 to 3 rounds of that piece, then we're gonna move into the bottom piece. We're gonna work on some holds. Even if you're walking, we're gonna work on some holds. So we have a dumbbell overhead hold, 5 to 10 seconds. Dumbbell front rack hold, 5 to 10 seconds. And then a dumbbell farmer's hold, 5 to 10 seconds, with the goal of going into each one as we come down the chain at the bottom. After that, sumo squat to windmill. For 2, we're just gonna bring 2 movements together and have some fun with that. 3 to 5 reps in total, and then some lateral ski jumps for 20 seconds, 10 second rest, 2 times to get some lateral movement and work on just heating up the body, getting the heart rate up a little bit. 3 to 5 rounds, working through that just to get used to the dumbbell, the kettlebell, whatever you're using for your holding, and then we're gonna get you into the workout. So the workout itself today is a little bit more on the quality side of things. I don't want you to worry about trying to get this done super fast. Try and keep it smooth, all right? But don't worry about necessarily unbroken or speedy, stuff like that. Just work on positions. You're gonna start off with 5 deadlifts per side if you're using a single dumbbell. If you're using doubles, you could just take 5 dumbbell deadlifts, all right? Then you're gonna move into a 50-foot farmer's carry, so holding the dumbbells to the side, all right? So if you have a hallway, if you have some space outside that you can do 50 feet or 25, 25, awesome. All right, if you don't, I'm gonna have a holding option for you. So you'll do your deadlifts, then you'll clean them, or sorry, you'll hold them to the side, and you'll hold them for an allotted time that I have at the bottom of the workout description, okay? From there, you'll go into 5 more deadlifts, then you'll clean them up, and you'll do a front rack carry for 50 feet, or a front rack hold for the same allotted time as our farmer's carry that we had. And then we're gonna move into 5 more deads, and then you're gonna clean them up, press them overhead, or single arm overhead, 50 feet overhead carry, or an overhead hold. And then you can go right into the next round if you like, or you can put the dumbbells down, rest, do what you gotta do, right? So break this up if you can in pieces, all right? So if you can, try and do your deads in your farmers. Maybe put it down after that. Deads, front rack carry. Maybe rest a bit. Deads, overhead carry, rest. Or, if you can, try and go right through the round, then rest, and continue on with the next round. So a couple different options. If you are a boss with the grip strength, you can hold on for a long time still while maintaining good position. Try and do all 3 rounds without putting the dumbbells down. Tough, but doable, you know, depending on what kind of loading you're using. But lots of different ways to play. Choose your options, like choose your own adventure. We'll have some fun today, but first let's warm you up. All right, guys, let's warm you guys up a little bit. Let's get those feet under those hips. We'll take the arms big, it's all up overhead, and then we're gonna shrug those shoulders. Keeping those ribs in, and then we're gonna pull them down. And we're gonna shrug them again. And then pull them down, keeping those ribs in. And one more time, shrug them. And then come down, and then take those hands out to the T. And turn the hands in, turn them out. In, turn them out, and turn them in, and turn them out. Big stretch. Scratch your back and reach to the elbow. We'll come back up, big stretch. Scratch your back on the other side, reach. Oh, big stretch. We'll come down all the way to the floor. And take those hands up the shins, nice flat back. We'll plant both hands on the floor, step back into our plank. We're gonna hold that for 3, 2, and 1. We'll extend those hips up. Then we're gonna
things up a little bit. There's a little bit of running and some walking this week, so I want to make sure those ankles feel good. From here, we'll come down into our table. Hands under the shoulders, knees under those hips. We'll cat-cow for one. Big stretch. Roll into the cat. Tilt and lift. And roll up. Good. Tilt and lift. And roll up. Good. From here, back to your table. We're going to press into those shoulders, set the hip. We're going to lift the knees about an inch off the floor, that quad plank. Just hold for 3, 2, and then lower back down to the floor. Keep the body set. Pull the shoulders together. Press up. Pull the shoulders together. Press up. And pull the shoulders together. And press up. From here, squeezing everything in, we're going to lift the knees again about an inch. And then press all the way up into that down dog as we walk those heels back and forth. Nice and easy. Good, we're gonna balance it out, come back into our plank. And from here, tucking and pressing, maintain those shoulders as we tiptoe those feet up. We're gonna roll ourselves up, big stretch. Clasp those fingers, press up and over and over. Come back to center, press straight ahead, rounding out that upper back a little bit. And take the arms back up and over and over. Good, come back to center, bring those hands down. That's rock and roll, you guys. If you'd like to do a little bit more warm up for yourself, a little bit of gentle stuff, please do so. Pause it, come back to us. We're gonna start on that first portion of the warm up. The first portion of the warm-up is going to consist of some inchworm K2Ns. So Raquel's going to get herself into that nice standing position. She's going to walk herself into her plank. So establishing her good, strong, hearty plank as she finds that good shoulder. And as she walks herself out, she's finding that engagement through the hollow of the ribs. And then she's going to squeeze one knee up to the elbow, or sorry, to the nose, and then come back into her plank. And then squeeze the other knee, getting that nice compression. That slight rounding through the body and into her plank. She'll hit her plank up first and then walk herself back in. She can choose to take the arms overhead. She can choose not to. Just standing up nice and tall is fine. But we'll get one more rep out of her at her own pace, just kind of walking out. Remembering as you're getting better with this engagement through the ribs and the shoulders, try and find it as you walk yourself into your plank. So by the time you get there, you're already set. To getting there and then set. Okay? You'll notice Raquel pauses for a brief moment in between reps as she doesn't rush those knee to noses. She takes that moment to feel her plank, get herself established and balanced, and then gets that next one. Okay? Stands tall, either the shoulders come up or just to the tall position. Excellent reps. Our next exercise is again a plank to plank walkout. So Raquel's going to either walk herself into a plank to get herself there or to step into it. She establishes her good plank here, and from here, what she's gonna do is just hold this plank for 3 seconds. Then she's gonna walk her hands out to her extended plank to whatever range she feels comfortable. Once she gets there, she's gonna hold that for 3 seconds, and then she's going to walk herself back to the plank. So then when she's ready, she comes back in, sets that hollow, holds for 3 seconds, and then walks herself. So on this next rep, when she walks herself back in, we're gonna show you an option from the knees, all right? So if you're comfortable in the full plank, you can do this portion through the full plank, or you can hold the plank from your knees. So Raquel's gonna lower into that nice hollow plank, nice and solid here, and then she's gonna walk her hands into her extended position to wherever she feels comfortable. This can give you a chance to get a little bit more range if you're not so comfortable doing it from and still get that and allow that good hold position. So she can walk herself back in, and then from here, she can either stay here for 3 seconds, hop into her plank, and make it yours. Okay. From there, she's gonna lay on her stomach. We have 2 pieces coming up on the floor. She's gonna work through a static hold in her arch hold. So her toes are gonna come together, her hands are gonna you're not quite comfortable with the full arch hold, Raquel can do that alternating hold. So she lifts one side up and she holds opposite hand, opposite foot. So she can hold that for 5 seconds and then she can switch. So she gets that nice balance on both sides. From there, she'll move right into her alternating arch up dynamic movements. So she'll just back and forth, right hand, left foot, left hand, right foot, nice and dynamic, working on kind of her breath, her rep, and just taking her time, reaching long, coming up, and coming back down until she's done a total of 10 reps. So isometric hold first into her alternating arching. If you're holding both hands, both feet in your arch hold, you're still going to be doing the alternating to work that opposite side kind of movement today, just for some coordination stuff, right? From there, she's going to stand up on her feet, and she's going to work on some balance and charging up her hamstring today. So she's going to show you the unloaded variation first, which is the back scale. So in terms of this exercise, she's going to pick her balancing foot, establishing that good solid big toe down, weight through the midfoot, nice and solid, and she's going to do just whatever she needs to for balance into her back scale. So she hinges at the hip. Another good thing to think about is pressing that heel to the back wall or whatever you have behind you, and then she stands tall. If you're getting a little bit better with that, what Raquel can do is if she wants to start transitioning to a loaded RDL, but not quite there yet, she can hold her hands here. Same concept, she's gonna take those hands down towards the knee. That back leg stays nice and strong. Her back is nice and flat. So if I had a PVC pipe between her head, shoulder, and hips, they would be touching all parts of the PVC. Okay. Last but not least, we have the weighted RDL. So Raquel's gonna show you the first one, holding two hands on the dumbbell. And she's just gonna do a couple reps at her own pace. So it's the exact same kind of criteria as what she just did, except now she's holding a dumbbell. So she's only taking the dumbbell to above the knee or just below. We're not trying to touch the dumbbell to the floor. We're really trying to create that good solid back position and that good hinge so you feel it in that glute hamstring as you're balancing. Another variation of this, moving into a single hand hold, Raquel can take the hand with the dumbbell and the same leg is going to lift as she lowers. So that what that's going to do is it's going to keep her slightly more balanced and square per se. And then she rises. Another variation is she holds the hand, the dumbbell, in the same leg she balances on. And again, I find for myself, this one is really challenging for me to stay square. So you really have to focus on staying kind of square torso, so it doesn't shift towards the side where the dumbbell is. So again, like I've said before, neither of these holds are right or wrong, better nor worse. They're just a little bit different in terms of what you have to use. So if you're getting comfortable with all of them, right, play around with all of them. There's nothing wrong with that, right? So experiment, play, and work the thing that challenges you the most. Right? Quick little recap of that. We have inchworm knee to nose for 3 to 5 reps. Plank to plank walkout 3 to 5 with a 3 second hold in each position. Arch hold 5 to 10 seconds of static holding, and then you're going to move into an alternating arch up for 10 reps total count. Single leg RDL 5 to 8 aside, and you're going to do 2 to 3 rounds of that to get that body kind of primed and ready. Okay? So pause the video, take that down, rock it. We're going to move into the next phase, which is going to be a little bit more kind of movement specific to the work set. All right, so pause. Take it down, come join.
dumbbell with the hand and the shoulder, so she really does have to work on that core strength to keep it up, okay? From there, she'll come down to the hang, which is our barber's hold, or suitcase hold if we're using a single, and she'll just stand nice and square, holding for 5 to 10 seconds. If she's using a single dumbbell, she would just transition to the other side and do that same sequence on the way down, okay? If she's using both, then she'll use both, 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 and continue, okay? So from here, if you'd like to practice the walk, Raquel's gonna show you a couple walks with the dumbbell. We'll use the other side to give that chance a little warm up as well. So she's gonna start with the overhead. For now, she's just gonna take a couple steps, basically just to get to me, to show you as she walks across the camera. So she establishes her good overhead position first. She's always pressing up into the arm and keeping the ribs in. She's gonna walk towards me as if she's walking to her target. And then from here, she would turn around and walk back the other way. And then when she gets to the other side, she's gonna turn around, bring the dumbbell down to the shoulder, into the front rack. Again, trying to keep it as still as possible as she makes her walk. So it's a nice way to work on her core strength, work on that nice ball balance. She'll turn around, way. Last but not least, which is actually first in the workout, the farmer's or the suitcase hold. So she'll hold that dumbbell next to the side, keeping it from swaying back and forth. She's keeping it still and close to her center. Okay. So a couple different options there, you guys. If you want to mix it and match, play with that. The hold, the walk, all right? You can make this warm up yours. If you are walking, it's not a bad idea. Do the first round as an isometric hold just to get your position strong, and then you can incorporate the walk as you go. Okay. As we get into the workout, we're going to show you what it looks like with two dumbbells as well, but for now, we'll stick with the single. Our next exercise is kind of a hybrid movement. So Raquel's going to get set up in her sumo stance. So she's going to stand in that nice wide stance squat. She's going to do one smooth squat. No tempo, just a nice steady squat working. And she'll stand tall. She'll take one hand overhead, and the other hand's going to be reaching down close to this one. And then she's going to rotate and place that low hand in between her foot or as far down as she feels comfortable. And then she'll come back up, switch hands, and then take it to the other side. So she's going to rotate down, and as she comes down, if this is as far as you feel comfortable, take it. Take it as deep as you feel comfortable. She'll come back down, set up again, squat, nice and sumo squat, and then set that position up just to work on a little bit of rotation, work on that nice overhead position. Don't feel like you have to go all the way to the floor, you guys. If you can just touch the fingertip, awesome. If you want to place something like a target down there, if you know you can't get all the way down, please do so. Make yourself and give yourself a chance to be successful. Or just take it to where you can make it and just feel that empty air and then come back up. Okay? So play with that. It's a nice chance to work rotation, nice chance to break up the ribs. From there, we're going to work that lateral ski jump for 20 seconds. So we'll get Raquel just to bust out some reps here, nice and steady, nice and smooth. So she's working on controlling that lateral energy, pausing briefly, changing directions. She would do that for about 20 seconds, then she would rest for 10. Down some reps. If you're not a jumper, right, you can do that long step variation. So taking that big step over the puddle and then just making sure you keep your feet dry. Good. You're still working on that balance and lifting that foot up off the ground. Right? But taking your time with that step. Again, too, if you'd like to add in that little hop you've been working on, you can do that single leg RDL jump. That's all good if you'd like to add that in. You don't necessarily have to today. We are going to play around, just focusing mostly on the lateral movement. But if you've been liking it, play with it, add it in, have some fun with it, but not totally necessary today. Okay? As a quick recap,
I'm giving that a big X.
Big X on that one. 3 to 5 rounds as a recap. We have our dumbbell overhead hold, 5 to 10,
touch the floor, especially depending on how big the dumbbells are, right? So if they're a little smaller, that's a long way down, so it requires a ton of mobility. So we'll get a couple more reps here, then she's gonna turn to the side so you can see that good back position. So as she pulls her hips back, her body stays nice and strong and solid. She's not letting those hips come up above the shoulders. She's keeping those hips nice and high, but the shoulders are above the hips. Feet are staying flat, and she's finding that nice, smooth pull. Okay. So the dumbbell deadlift, I'll take these dumbbells from her. Single dumbbell deadlift, like we've been playing around with for the past while. If you'd like to play with sumo style, you can. Taking it from between the knees, same back position, same location of the dumbbell for the most part, keeping it close to the center line, or if you'd like to work on the side like she was just as a single, same idea. Same back position, good strong connection to the ground with that flat foot, and making sure that back stays in that long straight position. Okay. Our next exercise is the farmer's carry. So Raquel has two dumbbells in her hands. You've seen the farmer's hold and the farmer carry with a single. Now she has her double dumbbells. So basically it's the exact same. She stands, she holds with two, staying strong, staying tall. She's gonna walk herself to me, then she's gonna turn herself around. You'll notice the dumbbells are not swinging back and forth, and her shoulders are pulled back, so she has that nice open chest and tall posture position. Okay, we'll get one more walk back. What you're not seeing is her shoulders rounding and her body rounding and putting her head forward to get herself there. All right, so tall, neutral chin, try and stay as tall and engaged as you can. If you're using that as just a hold today, same idea, you're just gonna stand with that good posture, dumbbells beside the body, holding nice and strong. The next exercise, again, is the deadlift, you just saw that one. And then we move into our front rack hold or carry. So Raquel's gonna have to clean the dumbbells up to her shoulders. So again, similar to the single, except she has two. The back of the dumbbell is resting on her shoulder, and you'll notice that the dumbbell is not straight up and down, right? We wanna use this to build strength, and in order to do this, we wanna make sure that her side and her arms are supporting those dumbbells a little bit as she does her walk. So we wanna engage that midsection as much as she can. This was competition, and this was totally allowed. Dumbbell straight up, give her. But we're working on core strength and training right now, so focus on those things that are gonna make that body strong. Okay? So again, you'll notice nice and tall, nice solid position. Arms aren't moving, she's staying super solid and taking her time. She's not rushing, she's not running with the dumbbells, she's walking. Okay. Her next exercise is the dumbbell deadlift again, and then she's gonna come into her overhead. So she's gonna clean the dumbbells up, press them overhead. I would suggest using a push press, all right, just to get the dumbbells overhead. So she push presses them up. She's pressing the dumbbells overhead, hard and strong, keeping the ribs in, and those dumbbells do not move. So I want you to think about holding up the world, all right? You're holding up the world with those arms and keeping those ribs pulled in the entire time. Chin is neutral, eyes are looking straight ahead to where you're walking. Whatever you're walking on, make sure there's nothing in your way, all right? But take your time, work on that good overhead position, all right? Single dumbbell overhead is a little bit easier in terms of maintaining position. So if you struggle with that overhead position, all right, the farmers in the front rack, you can get away with that double if you have issues overhead. But if you struggle with overhead, the single will make it a little bit easier so you can work on that good overhead position as she walks. What you'll do is you'll just half the distance with the single arm and then you'll flip sides with the other, okay? So this gives you a chance to work on a more overhead position. It'll allow you to get that arm straight, all right, and focus on those key points of performance, okay? So that is totally an option if you're struggling with the overhead to work on that single dumbbell. From there, we talked about different ways in terms of breaking this up earlier on in the video. So if you'd like a recap of those, go back to the beginning, play around with it. It's a cool workout, you guys. I hope you enjoy this one. Remember, I will have some times in place of the distance if you're doing that static hold variation. I'll have some times there at the bottom for you. And yeah, enjoy that. A little different way to build some core strength and some midline for today. I love carries. They're a good way to play around, but please focus on those key positions we talked about and make them as solid as you can. Right? Happy Wednesday, you guys.